my name's Selena Jones. I'm a registered nurse at Parkview Hospital Randalia in the emergency department. And today we're gonna talk to you about what to do if you see someone who has fainted or looks like they might be going to faint. So speaking of, this person doesn't look very good. Hi, ma'am, my name's Selena. Are you feeling okay? Okay, let's get you over to the bench here. Come around with me. Like I said, my name's Selena. I'm a nurse here. How long have you been outside?
2 hours.
Have you had any water? So a lot of times water and heat exhaustion and dehydration are a big thing right now, especially since it's June. So we'll wanna make sure that we can get her some water right away and then also get her out of the heat here. Are you feeling okay? Do you feel like you're gonna faint at all? Okay, so since she feels like she's gonna faint, I want her to lay flat on the ground. That way we don't have to catch her when she's falling out of the bench here. So if you feel okay, I'm gonna help you get to the ground, alrighty? All right, we're gonna get standing together. I'm gonna just put my hand here and we'll stand up. And then what we're gonna do is help lower her to the ground. Okay, so now this person is clearly fainted and we wanna make sure that we acknowledge her and hopefully she'll respond. So we'll kind of stimulate her and say, ma'am, are you okay? And she's not responding. And this is normal. Usually when someone faints, they're not gonna respond to right away. But the first things that we love to do as healthcare professionals is our ABCs. A is airway. We wanna make sure her neck is nice and in line with her shoulders to make sure that she can breathe appropriately. You don't want her slumped over. Another thing that you wanna do is make sure that all of her clothing around her neck is nice and loose. We don't wanna constrict that airway at all. And then B is for breathing. So is her chest rising and falling with her breaths? If it is, then that's great. And then C is circulation. So we wanna check a pulse. A lot of times people can faint for different reasons. Some can be very emergent, like a cardiac arrest. So good places to check is the carotid artery on the side. You never wanna check both at the same time because that can be very detrimental to the patient's health. I feel she has a pulse, so right now what we're gonna do is have someone call 911 and we'll get the ambulance here to be able to further evaluate her. So another thing we might wanna do for her is apply some ice packs because of this hot, hot day. It could be due to heat exhaustion. We wanna stay with her to make sure that when she wakes up, we can reassure her and let her know what happened and just to make sure that she is going to be okay until the ambulance arrives. When the ambulance arrives, they can evaluate her further and decide whether or not she is okay to go home or if she needs to go to the ER for more evaluation. So remember, people faint for a lot of different reasons. You want to help them to the ground, call 911, and stay with them until help arrives.